Hello everyone and welcome to Settlements and Survival. We're back here at Somerville and today we're going to be doing a marketplace thing. I didn't really know where I was going with this, but we'll see how it goes. So first things first, between last time and this time, I went ahead and retrofitted the inside of this place into a bar with a bunk room, you know, a little hotel or whatever. So basically this is no longer her house. This is the bar. There's the bar right there. Cooking station, some storage shelves, and then in here we've got the bed. So it's only going to sleep four. I'll put some furniture and rugs in here later, whatever. But it's just a flop shack for people who are staying over. So today, what I want to do is start building off of this area. I don't really know what I'm going to do. Looking up there, no, I got to turn the beacon on. Because I'm building, so I got to turn the beacon on. Because we're going to need a lot of people. But, of course, it's not wired because I unwired it. So let's go ahead and wire it. So, okay, first things first, we're going to watch me struggle with an idea that failed, but, you know, whatever. So what I want to do basically is make a barricade, a wall, something to block off the stairway, because that leads to the guard shack and the turret. So I thought I would do it with this thing, and, well, you'll see what comes with this, because it did not, the dimensions were wrong. I just couldn't get it to work, so it'll come down. So anyway, in the last video, or previous video, I mentioned that I was doing some research on the Megabill project, or I may have said it in a comment, I don't remember. It's Friday and I'm half asleep from working all week. So, but I did some research because I was concerned on the Megabill at how sluggish it was getting. I mean, when I did Greentop, I was crashing about every 45 minutes. I mean, the hard lock, not the buzz, but where it just freezes, like nothing happened. And then you dump to the desktop and you go back in and it's corrupt, so you have to go and reset the whole thing. And I mean, not corrupt, like it didn't blow the save out, but it wouldn't start Fallout. I had to go unplug the Xbox and clear the capacitors or whatever by tapping the power button. But I did that three times when I was building Greentop. And I'm like, okay, this is a problem. Something's wrong here. And of course, the 3 minutes it took to sleep for 8 hours, which was huge. So one of the things I did discover, I don't know. Now, all of this is just my personal experience. I don't know. I have no proof of any of this. This is something I observed. If you're seeing similar things, you may want to try these things. I don't know. But one thing I determined fairly consistently is the amount of time it takes you, the amount of real time it takes you to sleep, how long it takes you to sleep or wait in a settlement is pretty much directly related to how many settlers you have and how difficult their AI pathing is and or. Okay, I notice when I sleep in settlements with like 10 settlers less, it just pops right up. But 15, 20, 25 settlers, it starts taking a long time to sleep. And that's the only variable I could think of. So I'm thinking if you're having problems with taking a long time to sleep in survival, check your number of settlers and, you know, move them around or give them better pathing, easier ways to go or whatever. So there's that. Another key indicator I found during this research is when you play the game for a while, you know the little status messages you get up at the top left. A vertebrate has been sent to your location, or gears gotten from, you know, you picked up a thing or whatever. Basically, when you scrap stuff or make stuff, you get the little status message in the top left, right? If you play a while and that message stops appearing, that is your warning. That's the game, like, or maybe it's reserving memory. I don't know, but I can tell you this, on all the crashes that I observed, every single time it was after those messages stopped appearing. So that may be a good indicator for you, especially if you use vertebrates like I do. If you drop a grenade and that message doesn't come up saying the vertebrate's coming, it's time to maybe think about exiting the game and restarting it. So, but when I say restart, I mean go back to the dashboard. You know, don't just exit, don't just quit and exit save and then restart. You basically restart the whole game. Okay, that's the second thing I discovered. Again, I don't know if there's any relation. Maybe it's just my game that's doing it this way, but maybe it's something to try if you're having the same kind of issue. But my theory, the big theory in the Mega Build and why it was being such a pig is related to the size bar. I had a thought that Bethesda games have been historically poor at extended amounts of playtime, right? Because, oh, look, a new settler, and he self-assigned himself to a guard station. So there's your guard. He automatically assigned himself to guard duties. Okay, so anyway, so here's the theory. Again, I don't know if this is true or not. This is in my experience. But Bethesda games are poor at extended play because of items. Because if you think about it, I mean, the back end of the game is basically a big old database, right? Keeping track of all your stuff, all the locations of enemies, all the stuff you built, everything in your workshops, what you're wearing, what enemies are there, who's doing what. There's a lot of data this thing has to save, you know? So what happens, I think, is that over time, this quote database gets bigger and bigger and fuller and fuller. And if you've worked with databases, you know the more stuff you have in it, the longer it takes to look things up, because that's just the nature of the beast, right? Okay. So given that, I started looking at the limits this game has hard-coded in terms of, you know, I guess for performance issues, right? So it doesn't crash. That's the whole point. And the two big limits I kept coming back to are the size bar and the soft cap on salvage. Like, settlers won't add to salvage in the workbench if there are more than 100 plus 5 times your number of settlers items in it, right? It caps it. It won't overflow. And that, of course, I'm thinking is due to the data storage thing, right? It's all data storage. So then I'm like, wait a minute, I've got 30 size bars. So the game thinks I have 30 size bars with the building space. That's what it considers safe. And that's what it considers good for performance. Okay, theory. This is all speculation. Let's just keep, I'll keep saying that so nobody tries to think I've analyzed this other than what I've observed. And as we know, empirical data is the worst kind, but it's all I've got because I can't, you know, disassemble the executable. So the game gives you 30, size bars worth of stuff. So if I have 12 settlements and I break the size and I go over the size bar 3 times on all those settlements, I've only built 12 settlements, right? But I am over what the game is willing to give me to keep performance good for size bars. And I got to thinking, I'm like, man, I've really overbuilt Starlight. I've overbuilt Greentop. I've overbuilt Sunshine Tidy. I've overbuilt almost every single one of those things. So I'm like, you know what? Let's test this. So for the last, I don't know, week and a half or so, I've been spending about an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours every night going through all my old mega build settlements and tearing them the hell down. I've been refitting them to give them, you know, the basic stuff, right? Sheltered beds and food and whatever. But I've just literally been scrapping everything because I didn't want to store it, right? Because if you store it, the game still has to keep track of it. It's just in the workbench now instead of in the game world, but there are still items that it has to keep track of. So I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to scrap everything. I'm going to scrap it all. Just scrap everything. So, because I mean, I built them up, right? I built them, I recorded them, I took pictures of them, I posted them up. I mean, I have the build. So I've got the memory, right? So I don't need the stuff. I don't need the settlement anymore. It's immortalized in YouTube, unless, you know, YouTube deletes my videos or I go crazy or whatever. So far, I have torn down and rebuilt Sanctuary, Red Rocket, Abernathy, Sunshine, Oberlin, Grey Garden, mostly. There's something that I couldn't tear down that stairway. I couldn't tear down. I'll take the hit on the spiral stairway. But I tore down Grey Top, I emptied it out, I tore down Ten Pines, I tore down Zamonja, and I tore down most of Starlight. Which, I mean, I've still got the marketplace, but there's no fittings anymore. There's no decorations, there's no stuff, there's nothing but beds. You know, beds and shop counters and that's it. And I gotta tell you, I have noticed an immediate improvement in performance in the game overall. It hasn't crashed since. So maybe there's something to it, maybe there's not, I don't know. But then of course my next step was to go through the workbench and just start deleting things out of the workbench, the scrap I've accumulated. Because I mean, in the mega build I've got like 35 tons of junk. I mean, that's gotta be a problem for the database, right? And then if that didn't work, then I was gonna go start killing settlers because I got too many settlers maybe. Maybe that's the problem, I don't know. But I did notice that by scrapping everything, taking it all down, that my performance improved and my game got a lot more stable, even with the mods I was running. So, I guess that's really what we're doing here. So the mega build, we're gonna be back to it. I don't know what I'm gonna do next. It's a toss up between the Slog and Coastal Cottage. I do know that they're not gonna be as big as Greentop. They're not gonna be as involved as they once were. Because like I said, it's too much stuff. So anyway, what you're watching here is I built myself a guard tower, got myself a guard shack, because now I know I'm gonna need a guard thing. And I've got, you know, a guard station on the roof up that ladder, up the ladder. And then I've got this thing where this guard will control access to the back half of the settlement, you know, through this little two doorway checkpoint thing. And I think this came out pretty good. It was a little combination of metal and wood and scaffolding and stuff. And he can see out the door, you know, and controls access to the back. Put a turret up top there with my old, you know, stairway half height thing. And so now I'm looking, I'm like, okay, how do I want to do this? Because I do want stores, right? Because this is going to be a feeder, so it's going to have plants and crops, right? So there's going to be settlers here. But it's Somerville, and it's on the edge of the Glowing Sea. So I'm figuring if we have people who want to range into the Glowing Sea and do some hunting or scavving or whatever, this could be like their last stop outpost on the way in and out, right? So I want to have a weapons vendor, I want to have an armor vendor, and I want to have a junk vendor. So they can sell what they can sell to the weapons and armor people, and then just dump whatever they can on the scrap vendor over here. I haven't built the scrap vendor. We're going to be doing the weapons and armor here. But again, mixing materials, group selecting things, trying to get it to look, you know, suitably scrappy without being, you know, overbuilt. Because, I mean, it's going to be low. I don't know if I'll be doing, because it's almost done. You know, once you see the end of this, you'll see how filled in it's starting to get. And I think I'm going to just do a couple more things. I may record the next build, but I don't know if I need to. Because, you know, after this video, I went through and I, you know, dressed them out and added some more stuff and started filling in the back wall. Because this one's going to have a wall around the back of it. But, I mean, watching people build walls is just about the most boring thing in the world. Because it's like, okay, drop a rug, lift it up, drop a junk wall, lift it up, place it, take the mat out, put the mat down. No, it's repetitive, it's monotonous, there's no creativity involved whatsoever. So, yeah. So we'll see. I may just record it because I don't know. So there's definitely going to be more farmers. And I still have to build, the player house. She doesn't have a house anymore. So she needs a little place to call her own. But yeah, this Somerville was a little more fun than I thought. It was harder to get started on this part than I thought, because once I barnacled the workshop, you know, and the power station and stuff around the house, I'm like, okay, I pretty much filled that area. So now what I'm gonna do, I can barnacle off of what I already built, I guess, right? So we're going to do both versions of my shop, the one with the front door like this, with the fence, and then the one that's just the one that peeks through the half of that deep shack wall and roof. So yeah, that's what's going on here. I've also recently been working with, I've loaded Moribund World back up. Someone had commented on one of the videos saying, hey, you haven't done Moribund World in a while. And I'm like, yeah, the reason for that is both my Moribund World characters have that Start Me Up mod. I used the Start Me Up mod on them, and I didn't want to load them because I didn't know what was going to happen. Plus, I really missed that mod. I love alternate start mods, and I haven't seen one on Bethesda.net that is that fills me with confidence to try it, I guess is the way to say it. Not that they're good or bad. I haven't tried it. How do I know? But so yeah, I took Derek back out, and I think what I'm going to do is take one of your requests, y'all's request, Murkwater. And I'm going to try and build Murkwater in Moribund World, because man, a depressing Commonwealth and a depressing settlement location would seem to go hand in hand fairly well, you would think. So I took him out last night, discovered he had not even unlocked Murkwater. So I went down there and did that, you know, and cleaned out the charter, Suffolk County Charter School with the pink ghouls in it, and started looking around at it, trying to figure out what I want to do with it, because he doesn't use mods. He doesn't use settlement mods. He's just, you know, vanilla like her, where I do use mods, but nothing that's settlement based. So you can build the stuff in vanilla. Oh, man. One thing I do wish is that I didn't realize that she, this character here, has not started the automatron quest. So every raider group is not a Rust Devil group, but in his game, in the Moribund World guy, he has. So it was weird. I got to thinking, it's like, it's really strange that, you know, with all the different mods we have and the fact that the Rust Devils clearly can modify power armor pieces. I mean, that's where the Tesla armor comes from. They've figured out a way, or learned how, figured it out, whatever, how to upgrade and improve power armor. And I thought, what a shame it is that I can't have a power armor suit that's made of robot pieces like they've made the armor. Because, I mean, if they can turn robot pieces into armor and they know how to modify power armor, they could theoretically make a power armor you know, piece set out of robot pieces. I think that'd be cool as hell, wouldn't it? But, you know, go run around a power arm with a protector on head. That would just be dumb. It's like, look at me, I'm Captain Dildo. Yay! No, that would be just weird. But it'd be funny, right? I mean, you know, I don't know. Maybe there's a mod for it, I just haven't seen it, whatever. Speaking of mods, the other day, so when I was tearing down Red Rocket, I wanted to make a depot, because I realized that I didn't have a depot-style settlement anywhere in the mega build, where a depot being defined, of course, as a settlement that is linked to the network that has no settlers in it, so I can store stuff there safely. And the reason that occurred to me is because after Greentop and I went started tearing stuff down, I got, I'm not kidding you, 9 settlement attacks in a row, 3 at once. I mean, they just kept coming and coming, and I was just sleeping, you know, just apes coming. And yeah, having 3 at once is a pain in the ass, getting the coin to come up heads 3 times in a row on the same load was time consuming. But I'm like, okay, I'm gonna do this. So I went to look for the provisioner. So I got the Vault Tech thing out. I got the Vault Tech, settler management system from the Vault 88 DLC. Got it out, hooked it up, and did the end. Okay, it's dark. Am I gonna? Yeah, time to go to daytime. Okay, so we're getting closer to the end. So what I did is I used the vault. I couldn't find the provisioner. He wouldn't come. Every time I slept, he would never show up. And since I have two provisioners, you know, one from Sanctuary and one from Starlight, I was like, where the hell is the Starlight guy? He was never show up. So I got the seller management system, the Vault Tech thing, right? Went there, unassigned him as a provisioner, and assigned him to the crops that I had, because I had, you know, razor grain. So, okay, good, whatever, piece of cake. 2 weeks go by, he never comes out, never shows up in the field, just never shows up. I'm like, where the hell is the guy? I'm thinking maybe I'm missing him because he's wandering around, maybe he got confused, whatever, maybe he's bugged, I don't know. So I'm like, okay, fine. So I went back to the terminal, loaded it up, and did assign him to a guard station. So I'm like, okay, I'll assign him to a guard station, go away for, you know, a day or two, come back. He'll be at the guard station because, you know, they're on the guard station 24/7. Come back, he's not there. Unassign him, he's not there. Literally, just I've got a settler in Red Rocket that I cannot find. I'm like, you know, I don't know. So I'm looking online, trying to figure there's a solution to this, because I'm thinking, man, this is kind of bug. Somebody must have done something. I realized that the settlement management software is now available on the Xbox. I did not know this. So I loaded it up and marked. So I'm like, cool, I've got this. So I loaded up, put the tape in, and say, mark the provisioner, right? And it gives the quest, settler, you know, provisioner marked or whatever. Go to the map, there's no pip anywhere. Literally, this I have Schrodinger settler. He's both there and not there. I'm like, what in the hell is going on here? So I finally use the settlement management software to bring him to assign him to something. Like I unassigned him, assigned him to something or whatever. And then he showed up. No, that's not what I did. What I did is I found him, right? And then I just moved him to Starlight. And it did it. I was like, sweet, it moved him to Starlight. And then I went to the terminal and I went to the Starlight part and I assigned him as a provisioner back to Red Rocket. And it worked, the line came back. I'm like, sweet. So now I have 0 settlers at Red Rocket. It's my depot, I have all my stuff there. And then like a week later, it got attacked. It's like Red Rocket's under attack. I'm like, I have 0 settlers here. This should never, so apparently the game is bugged in that it thinks there's a settler there even though the count is 0. This ghost settler is going to be completely attached to the settlement forever. So the takeaway here, the moral of the story is, don't reassign provisioners with the Vault Tech terminal. It will bug the crap out of your game. Don't do it. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe you just get settler management software you can on the PS4. But I don't know. Just have to wait for the provisioner and hope you can find him. I really don't know what the hell happened there. So yeah, here's the second one. The second version of the shop. This one's a little bit larger than the typical, you know, hut. I made them both kind of big because I wanted them to have a back so that when I did the fencing, it would be, you know, more of an enclosure. And of course, a building gives you better defense if it's bigger. But yeah, it looks pretty nice, right? The little back half of the courtyard there with the bar and the bar on the right and the campfire. I put some stuff around the campfire, a bench, a chair, a Vault Tech crate. I put one of those tables with the umbrella on it. I will say, after building with USO for so long, there are certain things I miss about not using USO. Things like the tableless umbrellas, you know, the patio umbrellas and the beach umbrellas with the stick. You can just put those anywhere. I miss those. I miss having barrels. I miss having boxes and crates. I miss them very, very much. And of course, I miss the vendor mats. I miss the vendor mats a lot. Along with, well, that's pretty much it. But yeah, the barrels, the boxes, the crates, the umbrellas, just the, and of course the half walls. I mean, that goes without saying. I miss the half walls more than and the double high junk walls. Basically anything made of wood, I'm gonna miss that. I don't miss all the extra metal and 3-texture stuff. I mean, it's nice, but I'm keyed to this kind of wood, so I don't think about using those things. Okay, where am I going? Oh, I'm getting another bed. Grab another bed out of the thing here, la-di-da. My Razor Green feels looking pretty good. I took Carlos Soto's tip and rugged them, and they work fantastic. Went down there pretty fine. So how are we doing on time? We're getting close. I think we're getting close to the end here. Yeah. So I'm looking. I'm all, do I want to build anything else right now, or is that enough? I'm looking at the clock thinking, yeah, I don't know. Oh, I noticed there's another settler, and I can't find him. Where's my settler? So I got a guy in the bar, right? I got two people in the fields, and where is the settler? Because I'm going to stick him on one of the shops, or her. I don't remember. Is it him or her? I'm like, where the hell is he, man? He's here, right? I spend entirely too much time looking for lost settlers, man. But yeah, this is coming along. It's going to be a little outpost fortress, you know, marketplace town thing out here. Is he in the guard station? No, it's not up here. Well, I do spend a lot of time looking for this, but I'm up here. I'm like, oh yeah, I need to wire this up. Let's go ahead and wire this up. While I'm here, let's go ahead and wire this thing up. Put this here. Here's another no response influence. The street light, which is basically the power pylon with two industrial lights on it. Because it's, you know, it's an emitter, so it doesn't really matter. You can do that. I use that a lot still. Because I still like the look of that. It still looks good. And yes, a lot of exposed wires here. I'm going to keep the wires exposed for this sort of thing. Oh, there he is. Come here, dude. Go to work. And go him again and put him in his bed. I can't see it through here. So let's go through around the side. Sign into the bed. Wait. Make sure he's assigned. Okay, good. I think that's it. Yep. Going to eat and drop out. And okay, so here we are. Here is our proto market. We've got a weapons vendor, we got an armor vendor. Of course, the weapons vendor has a fancier shop because he makes the most money because he's a weapons vendor. And of course, I'll be dressing those out. I fixed that gap later on with one of the warehouse I-beams. It just slid right in there. Had to rotate it a couple of times, but it did it. Here's a guard station. He's gonna get a desk and a table and a bed. And here's the back of the wall. I was gonna put a turret there, but it didn't work. It blocked all the pathing. And the pathing here is already getting weird. These buildings are a little bit complicated for them. But yeah, this is looking pretty good. Gonna put another turret behind here so I can cover that spawn spot that's over there by the end of the workshop. Dress this out a little bit. But yeah, and of course, you know, junk wall at the bottoms of the fences, and this big huge gap under here is just looking like crap. But again, you've seen me do that before, so you know how it's gonna work. Just rug it, drop it, slide it under there. Check the pathing, and then off you go. So the next time, I guess we'll see what happens. We'll see if I can have enough to build or whatever. And here's our Somerville coming along. And I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching. And I will see you in the next one. Take care.